OK, so when we looked at calling an API, we finished by getting some data back in this big dump of data, and it was a little confusing. That data we got back was JSON. So what I want to do now is show you how to navigate that JSON structure, because it's a little scary at first glance. JSON is a standard data format that's used to pass data back and forth, but it can be very intimidating at first glance. What you see here is the actual JSON that was returned by my API call when I passed in a picture of a polar bear and asked the Analyze Image service to tell me what was in the image. This is the data that came back. But it said it looks a little scary when you just look at it all displayed that way. How would I read this using code? Well, the first thing you want to do is there's a whole bunch of websites and things out there called JSON linters, like lint you find in a dryer. And what that will do for you is if you take some JSON and you put it into a linter, it'll format it nicely so that you as a person have an easier time reading it. So that's going to make your life easier. First thing I do when I get a chunk of JSON is put it onto go to a website that does linting, copy and paste the JSON there, and then I look at it this way, and I look at it and I say, oh, now I kind of see what's coming back. What I'm getting back is, so I had a variable called results, which held the code that was passed back, and I can see it gave me back a color that was in the image, and it told me the dominant color in the foreground and the background, any accent colors, and whether or not it was a black and white image. For some reason, it gives you back tag twice, not sure why. And then it gave me a description telling me the tags of what it saw inside the image. It's a bear, polar bear, it's an animal, a mammal, outdoor, it saw water, white, large, and so on. It tells me a caption that it generated. This is a large white polar bear walking in the water, and a request ID, which just uniquely identifies my call to that API. So this is what actually was passed back when I called the Analyze Image service, and I passed it my image. This is what it found inside the image, based on the parameters and so on I passed in. Now, how do I use this in code? How do I actually write code that reads through this messy-looking JSON, even though it is very structured? Basically, what you'll notice is there's a pattern to how the JSON data looks. It's basically a series of key pairs. So you have a key, request ID, and a value, the value of the actual request ID itself. Sometimes the pattern is you have a key, and for that key, there's a series of subkeys and subvalues. So for color, you'll notice there was, for each color, it said there's the dominant color foreground, dominant color background, dominant colors, and for each of those is a value. So this is an example where I have a series of subkeys and subvalues for the key of color. Or for a particular key, you might have a list of values, like we did with the tags. So tags is the key, and for the tags, there's multiple values that are specified. So it saw it was a bear, it knew it was an animal, it knew the picture was outdoors, it saw water, it knew it was white. So all of those are tags. So you'll see the square brackets indicate it's a list of values. Those are all different tags. So they're all, it's a list of values that go with the tags key. So when we want to read this with our code, we have to know which of these structures we're dealing with. So there's different methods we use to basically read through the JSON, and we have to read it slightly differently depending on whether it's a key value, key and subkeys, or key and a list of values. Let's say you want to retrieve the value from just a straight key value. This is the easiest one to do. What we do is we're going to import the JSON library, and then what we can do is with our results, so I'm assuming when I called the code and I called the web service, the results were passed back to a variable called results. So results is the name of the variable that contains that big JSON string. So all I have to do is say, give me the value of the request ID. And basically, it'll return to me that value for the key. So you pass it the key, it will return to you the value. Now, what if I need to retrieve a value that's in one of these key subkeys? So I have the color key, and for the color key, I want to know the dominant color in the background. Like, what's the primary color of this image? In this case, white. So what I have to do, and you can think of it kind of like a series of file folders, I have to say, well, go into the color key, and then in the color key, go down to the dominant color background. So think of this as like folder and subfolder, and then say go to color, dominant color background, that's the key name I want, and it will return the value of white. So it returns the value of the key I specified. So I said, think of this like a folder and a subfolder. Might be an easy way to think of how you drill down and specify the key you want when there's subkeys. Now, if you have a value in a list, so in my JSON when it came back, for description, the tags, there was a whole list of possible values, actual values returned for the tags. So what if I want the first value in the list? Well, if you think back to that module we did on lists, we had index positions to indicate first index 0 is the first one in the list, 1 is the second in the list, and so on. So what I can do is I can say, use that description, say go to description tags. So go to the description key, under description key, go to the tags key, and then just give the index number of the particular tag you want back, 0. Of course, most of the time, and that will return bare, but most of the time you probably just want all of the tags that came back. So to do that, you would just use a loop. So I can simply say for each item in results, description tags. So if you go to description tags, for each item in this list, print it on the screen. And that allows me to go through literally and display every single tag that was returned in the JSON. In addition to needing to read JSON, there's going to be times when you might need to create JSON too. You might be required to create JSON to pass to a web service. So if that's the case, how do I actually create JSON with my code? Usually we use dictionaries. So dictionaries have that same concept of key-value pairs. So since JSON has key-value pairs, the Python dictionary is like the perfect mapping to it. So the good news is you can use the JSON library, and you can actually use the JSON dumps method, give it a dictionary, and it'll create JSON from the dictionary. But exactly how you create the dictionary depends on which of those three structures you want to create. If you just want to create key-value pairs, like I might create a dictionary object here for a person. We saw this when Christopher covered dictionaries in collections. I have a first name of Christopher, a last name of Harrison, and that's two key-value pairs I'm putting in the dictionary. And then you can add additional key pairs if you need to. I add another key called Seattle with a value of a key of city is a value of Seattle. And then I use the JSON library to say, hey, use JSON.dumps. This is one of the features of a library. Pass it the dictionary, and that will return a JSON object. And then if I print that out, you can see it shows me the three key value pairs. So if all you need is key value, key value, key value, just create a dictionary. Use JSON.dumps to create that into a JSON object. What if I need that key subkey? Okay, if you need those subkeys and subvalues, it's a little more complicated, but what you're really doing is creating a dictionary in a dictionary, if that makes sense. You'll have to play with this to practice it and get used to it. So I have that person dictionary, which contains Christopher's first name is Christopher, last name is Harrison, just like I did before. But imagine if I had a JSON object that showed us our staff directory. And each staff position, there's a person associated with it. And for that person, we know their first name, their last name, what city they live in, and so on. So I might have a staff dictionary, which has a key of program manager. And the program manager is a particular person. And for that person, there is first name, last name, city, and so on. So what I do in this case is I create this staff dictionary. And then I create the key program manager for staff dictionary, but instead of just saying it equals Christopher, I say it equals the dictionary object which contains Christopher. And then you actually get that nested set of subkeys when you create a JSON object from that dictionary nested in a dictionary. If you need to create a JSON object that contains that list of values, then instead of putting a dictionary in the dictionary, you actually put a list in your dictionary. So again, in that module on collections, we learned how to create lists. So what I can do is create my person dictionary. First name is first key is equal to the value Christopher. The last key is equal to the value of Harrison. And then I create a list of all the programming languages he knows. And I say he knows C#, Python, and JavaScript. So this is just a Python list object. Then I create a new key in my person dictionary called languages and set it to the entire list. Then I take that person dictionary, change it into JSON, and now I have that list embedded in my JSON. So those are the three basic scenarios you'll be playing with if you're trying to create JSON with your Python code. It takes a while to get used to this. Chances are you won't get the code right on the first time you have to read JSON or write JSON. So a couple of tips to help you out. One, use print statements all over the place to help you debug. When you do a JSON.dumps to create the JSON object, print that JSON object out to make sure it looks the way you expected. When you're trying to read JSON, you may want to do print statements to show the values you read and gradually work it out until you figure out the right syntax to get the right subkey and the right list item. So play around with print statements. They will really help you master your JSON skills. Use a JSON linting tool. Just go on the web, search for JSON linter, and then you copy and paste your JSON into it, and it'll give you that nice formatted view, but it's a lot easier for a human to read, so you can see the pattern of keys and subkeys or keys and list values and see which ones go together. And finally, I actually find it useful the first time I call an API that returns JSON. I actually usually copy and paste that JSON linted, and then I keep it in something like a Word document on the side to refer to as a reference as I'm trying to figure out how to navigate the JSON and read what I need. So that's the theory. Let's try it out in practice in some code.